Okay, we are here at Sobel Hotel for the preliminary. This is selection of top 25. Now we are on our second and final category. This is the Kapitan Kres Bayaning Mangingisda. So panel of judges will be coming from the Kres Philippines, from the committee, a selection body. And then meron din tayo coming from the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources of the Department of Agriculture. So this is the selection team. So yung pong ating mga taga DA is naka-connect sa Zoom. So they are in their office. Okay. So they will be part of the panel of judges. So we are about to start. Okay. So we have here Denzel and Lucille to present the nominees for Bayaning Mangingisda. So the Bayaning Mangingisda or Kapitan Kres Bayaning Mangingisda has been going na for 3 years. So this is already in the third season. Wherein nominees coming from all over the Philippines, from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao has been submitted to the Kapitan Kres Bayaning Mangingisda at Magsasaka Search Committee. So for today, 25 ang kukunin out of the qualified nominees. So this morning, nakuha na po or ginudge naman yung mga bayaning magsasaka nominees, and we already have the 25 nominees. So this screening is of course through the guidance and of course through the assistance ng the DTI. Okay.
you po.
And shares his technical know-how and best practices for fish game. He has gained recognition and received many awards for his achievements. So here is a short video clip.
Sa kapitan Chris, bayanin mo sa
years old, fisherman and chairman of Sea Farm C and B Farms. This simple fisherman takes on a leadership role in helping his fellow fishermen by guiding them and addressing their needs. He works towards strengthening the organization, making sure that each member is registered to the sea to become progressive fishermen. During disasters and typhoons, he seeks help from city officials, barangay councilors, and the mayor to assist the community. He also serves as the Sea Farm C and B Farm C chairman, dedicating himself to improving the fishing industry and bringing happiness to the community. Thank you.
policy, we are compliant of the Magna Carta of Women. 80% of the council members are women, and together we are happy and content to serve the district court of the city. And in 2016, we won as the outstanding pharmacy in the Gawin Sapa Search of Europe Fisheries and Aquatic Resources. Through my leadership as a city council chairman, we have assisted the LGU in the strict implementation of the city fishery ordinance in terms of protection, conservation, management, and proper utilization of the fisheries code and aquatic resources. As a leader, I took part in the crafting of resolutions and amendments to the city fisheries code. Through it, I can say that I have attained fulfillment of all my purposes in making San Fernando City abide to the provisions of the Fisheries Code of 1991, known as the Republic Act 8550, as amended by Republic Act 10654. I'm strengthening fishery ordinance in the city. A fish inspection unit at the Auxiliary Wet Market was established. I was trained as fish warden, and at the same time, fish examiner, which I lost my skills in the fish inspection area, while in a steam sea park scene of detailed as inspector. All fish that enter the market are inspected with payment of 30 pesos per manure. If suspected delivery code, it will be scientifically examined. In my capacity, subject for an administrative fine of 5,000. In recognition of the efforts and sacrifices of the fishermen and the city, first recommended the annual celebration of the one annual staff, of which the city was the first to celebrate this event. And now we get the one annual staff at Manila staff celebration. In 2009, I have assisted the Mission Fox of Rabe San Vicente in the cancellation of the approved plan of a 33,600 square meter building claimed by a private person. This plan lasted in 4 years, but no decision was made by the board. During the time of GENR Secretary Jensa, he launched the program People's Hour, which gave me the chance to vote up the issue. With the support of entering as politician, the same problem was solved and eventually answered. In terms of livelihood, I was able to link the priority offered in Coprande Cantonment with the regional business office one. The regional office awarded to operate in 2 sets of land. This kind of collaboration paved the way for uplifting their life and promoted sustainable production and contributed security in the city. I have also assisted and made some associations of the city in terms of capacity building and other neighborhood projects to support their members, develop their skills, and encourage them to fight for their rights as a woman and participate in other activities related to fisheries management. I hope that this story of mine can inspire other women, not only in our community, but in the entire country, to push through with their advocacies and believe in themselves that whatever man can do, we as women could do it as well. Always remember that challenges are always present in many aspects of life, but a tough woman can surpass it all through faith in God.
Director of Regional Fisheries and Director for National Fisheries. Mr.
RC category. And MMK second runner up Malinis at Masaganang Malagata 2017. Mr. Alexander is a dedicated and accomplished leader in fishing industry. He has been a pharmacy member for several years and become a regional fisher folk director and national fisher folk director. He is committed to improving the livelihood of farmers and fisher folks in Region 2, which includes Batanes and Babuyan Channel, where fishing is the main source of livelihood. As a member of NFARMC, he can further extend his help to fellow fisher folks in the Philippines. In recognition of his efforts, he received the Kagawad Saka Award in the FARMC category in Philippines. Next would be Mr. Rashef Valencia from Apay, Cagayan, a 37 years old fisherman, president of, from Makane Fisher Folk Association. He is a dedicated and successful fisherman who is committed to helping his fellow fisher in the town of Apay. He has been appointed as the president of the fishermen in Apay and has fought for their rights. He has received numerous awards for his efforts to assist his fellow fishermen, including providing trainings and acquiring equipment from B4, LG, such as water pumps, fishing boats, fish nets, and more. Looks out for illegal fishing and trolling to avoid damaging fish habitats. For each harvest, the chef gives 10% of their earnings to the association, which is a fund raised or used in terms of specifically by FSC and No Harvest. Here are some proof of Mr. Griffin in his group. A video call from Mr.
Thank you.
commercial fishing areas to prevent the depletion of fish in municipal areas. Local communities in the municipal bodies. Well, as chairman of the municipal Hermanas Laguna. A 15-year-old fisherman, resident of Pharmacy, auditor sa kahanapang museum ng Los Banos Incorporated. So he has a Linislawa project for sustainability and livelihood. Aside from fishing, he has also ventured into other livelihoods such as poultry farming and construction work. Share them. from the Municipal Agriculture Office. She organized and trained women in fishery and farming community. She spearheaded a project for alternative livelihood and disaster risk reduction during typhoons and the pandemic. As a community facilitator, she shared her knowledge learned from the seminars and national organizations, and she advocated for the rights and voices of women in fishing and farming. Her determination and hard work have been contributed significantly to the betterment of the lives of fisher folks and farmers in the province. Next would be Mr. Bermelio Alforque from Zamboanga del Norte, 77-year-old farmer, fishery consultant, and regional director of the D4 Region 9. Chairman of Regional Agriculture and Fishery Council, a committee of fisheries and aquaculture. Mr. Virgilio is a community organizer for Fisher Folk, has a strong collaboration with LGUs, NGOs, and CSOs. He is a business leader for the fishing industry. Next nominee would be Imbag Soko from Zamboanga del Sur as well, a 59-year-old fisher, a chairman of MFARMC, a fisher of the Vice Mayor's office, a president of Cebu Fall Fisher and Folk Association. Mr. Imbag organized an organic association for fisher folk, and he coordinates with relevant agencies and NGOs. As a FARMC chairman, he identified landing trees along the coast and fish sanctuary, guarding the breeding grounds of fish day and day and night. As the FARMC chairman, he leads tree planting along with the coast and guarding of the fish sanctuary day and night. He passed an ordinance to protect sea water. Would be Levan Royo Abiba from Misamis Oriental, a 33-year-old fisherman and a member of Baybay Alupit Fisherfolk Organization. Mr. Garban has involved in distributing or giving fish to those in need during the times of excessive catch. They also create fish aggregating devices provide shelter for the fish and making fishing easier. The project is funded by wealthy individuals or investors, and the fishing aggregating devices are sold to those who can afford them. Mr. Gavan provides aid to those in need while also engaging in commercial activities. Here are some proof of Mr. Gavan.
Now, our next is Judith B. Texas from San Patita, Davao Oriental, a 55-year-old fisherman, police officer, and executive of the LGU, chairman of MFARMC, member of Batay Daga. So he is committed to enforcing the law and protecting the environment by firmly arresting anyone involved in illegal fishing regarding their background. He ensures that laws are implemented partially and effectively by working closely with local agencies such as DA and LGU. With his efforts, illegal fishing activities were stopped, which contributed to the preservation of the local environment. Fisher Boats and Ferry Boat Association, president and deputy fishing warden. actively advocates for the creation and strengthening of fish factories for sustainable fisheries. So he takes it upon himself to have a fisherman registered in the municipal agriculture office, and as well as their fishing boat, he encourages them to avail of free insurance for fishing boats, fishermen, and also encourages to avail the life insurance from PCI that they provide. So he's able to expand his horizon in school and out of school youth from different municipalities who encourage to participate in the Coastal Cleanup Drive, mangrove and tree planting. So he's also vocal in his cause to help the marginalized fisher folk by teaching them how to care for the marine ecosystem. He is able to facilitate the distribution of fishing gear and other systems not only to the fishermen in his barangay, but to other neighboring barangays. He shed light to students on the importance of caring for the environment, support and nilabantay dagat during seaport and food patrolling. He initiated a campaign signed by more than 440 fisher folks from the communities to block the establishment of the 25-hectare MPA at the back of the Pacific Island. In order to negotiate with the Office of the Provincial Agriculture of Davao del Sur that they would be allowed to transport tourists from the mangrove area to the Pacific Island. So here is supporting documents of Mr. Tercito D. Cajegas. So one fun fact about Mr. Tercito D. Cajegas, in order to gather more tourists, he nagpa-interview siya sa isang radio na sinabi niya, ang tinanong sa kanya is ano yung kakaiba doon sa lugar nila, at ang sinabi niya ay merong something doon sa lugar nila. Kapag hinahanap nila, kapag hinahanap siya ng mga tourist kung nasaan yung something na yon, ay sinasabi niya na nandiyan lang yan. So naging parang, kaya naging famous ang lugar nila is dahil sa kanya. Next one is Mr. Ramir C. Rendon from the Nalusan City, South Cotabato. He is 55 years old, the president of Unified Tuna Handlers Association, a chairman of City Fisheries and Aquatic Resource Management Council, a director of Regional Fisheries, vice president of East Coast Tour Guide Association of Pula. So he belongs to various background in various organizations that aim to provide the livelihood of fisher folk and promote sustainable fishing practices. In 2018, he became the chairman of the City Fisheries and Aquatic Resources Management Council and made 21 resolutions to improve policies for the benefit of marginal fisher folk. He actively participates in various local cleanups and mangrove planting activities and assists different organizations and government agencies in organizing programs and projects for the fisher folk. He is also a leader in implementing the elimination of hunger death alongside the PFPA and FPA. Here are some of the pictures or the supporting images of Mr. Ramirez. Next up is Mr. Basil P. Mustafa from Burong Balas and Digalang, Cotabato City. He is 52 years old, a fisher and chairman of the Maco Mountain Rivers Cooperative, former director of Regional Fisher Boats, Maguindanao, Tarsi, area of the sea. He has a lot of certificates and nursing trainings, and this includes a sealing economic community and European Union generalized scheme of reference plus, Yellow Cotabato of the Fishery Training Fair, Fish Ward and Refreshment Training, adaptation of high intensive hatchery, agriculture dialogue and information network groups program, Seal Society Organization Conference, Annual Customs Center Report Preparation for the So he is indicated fisher folk was really engaged in capture fishing since elementary school to support his family's livelihood. He has organized a cooperative for marginalized fisher folk of the coastal area to help sustain and improve the living conditions of its members. He is the chairman of the City Fisheries and Aquatic Resources Management Council, which works closely with the law enforcement, specifically in Bantay Dagat, to eliminate illegal fishing practices such as using dynamite. He conducts an informational education campaign to encourage fisher folks in the coastal area to protect and preserve the mangrove.
practice of this management council, CPARC, under the leadership of Chairman Mr. Basil Mustafa, would like to highlight the impact of your projects of mangrove plantation in the coastal areas. And along the rivers of the Ugandan Mindanao. This will also highlight the future of the coastal capture fishing. The Capital Plans recommend to the City Planning Development Councils for a possible location of those settlers in the coastal for a safe and permanent housing.
He is generous in sharing his cat as
project came from the government, indicating that he is involved in project that aims to improve the livelihood of his fellow.
Next would be Mr. Alex Mercado for the Kilda.
okay, 31-year-old fisherman, security, construction, and a content creator. Mr. Alex is dedicated to protecting marine life. He actively rescues individuals in the sea and helps remove fish from fishing nets, ensuring that they do not suffer and die needlessly.
Efforts during the COVID-19 pandemic. He received recognition for outstanding quarantine.
So while we are tabulating the score, so we like to announce that the selection for top 25 is initial ready. So in the morning, this morning we have actually chosen top 25 for farmers. And now we're about to consolidate and tabulate the top 25 naman for fishers. So maraming salamat po sa mga sumubaybay. So this tabulation and selection of top 25 is under the guidance and supervision of the DTI representative. So our panel of judges coming from the Department of Agriculture, specifically from Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources, and from the selection body of CREST Philippines. So maraming salamat po. I think mamaya we can announce the top 25. At alam po namin, medyo excited na po yung pong ating mga magigiting na mga bayani na nominado dyan sa Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So, we will be tabulating siguro by before 5. Yeah, I think we can announce. Yeah, I think we can announce before 5. Top 25 for bayaning magsaka, and then the top 25 for bayaning manginda. So, and then we will also announce later on the next schedules for para naman po sa ating quarterfinals, yung top 10. Because this top 25 na pala po, okay, will be subjected into an interview. Okay, so top 25 po, pipiliin po dito yung top 10. But all of the top 25 will undergo an interview by Zoom. And then we will announce the schedule, and then from top 10 we will be selecting naman yung top 5 based on the interview by the panel of judges, and then top 5 will be ranked into grand winner of grand winner up to fourth runner up. So subaybay po kayo, tutuklaban po kayo mamaya, and then we will announce. Maraming salamat po.